focused on those first couple of rocket barrages and call downs. Winter Wyvern is a response by Alliance. It didn't work out too well for them in game two, but hopefully they'll find some better openings. And I think it's another good hero that offers some sort of defense for the gyrocopter.
Yeah, I think that you just need something also that is an aggressive hero that allows you to continuously re-engage. Winter's Curse, obviously one of the best initiating spells. They really didn't use it as effectively as I think they could have, though, in that last game. Mm-hmm. I felt like there were just, like, dead periods and stuff like that, where the Winter's Curse was used, like, almost just as a panic ability. You can't use it as a defensive ability anymore. You have to, like, use it as a key initiating spell. The Cold Embrace did a lot last game, too, but I just didn't really feel the impact of the Winter Wyvern like I would have liked. I think part of it is, too, that he decided to go for, like, the Force Staff, going for, like, the Glimmer Cape. That would have made a difference. The Winter's Curses definitely were subpar, though. And, again, they go for the Dazzle. That hero wrecked Alliance last game. Actually wrecked them.
Alright, we need a mid or a carry now for Team Secret. In your experience, when it comes to drafting, do you feel it's more... I feel like it's more valuable leaving your carry open. Whereas before, I felt like in previous patches, maybe picking up the mid a little bit later gave you a better advantage. Just because the mid is oftentimes so focused. Alliances
turn to pick. Okay. I don't know. Okay, that's Ember.
From your experience, what do you think?
I think the mid lane is... It's definitely... I don't know.
Because I guess for me, in previous patches, the mid matchup was a little bit more determined on this hero versus this hero. But now, while that is a factor, there's so many supports roaming into the middle lane, there's bottle crowing, there's stacking that goes on. Even a bad matchup can still work for the middle lane. If that makes sense.
Yeah, I'm trying to think right now, like, of all the stuff. Like, before, just, like, the history of mid lane is, like, before it was entirely matchup-based, and then everyone started doing bottle crowing, and then it became irrelevant.
Yeah.
And then ganks happen nowadays. I think your mid laner, though, is, like, just, like, your strategy hero. The hero that you kind of reflect heavily on what you want to be doing.
Okay.
Because if you pick, like, you did in game one, where they take the Tidehunter, then you have to almost exclusively play around the Ravage.
Yeah.
Whereas if you pick a hero like Lina, then she's your setup killer every single time. But it took so long. I had a really...
Yeah, no worries. I think Tidehunter is a very special...
It is, but then Magnus is kind of similar in that regard, too.
Yeah, like Magnus pretty much, actually makes... I think it's a better,
like,
example.
There's no real losing matchups nowadays in Dota. Almost make everything okay nowadays just because you jungle stack.
Right. Okay.
It's kind of bad because the mid matchup isn't as important anymore in a lot of ways. Like, the first 3 minutes of the mid lane used to be, like, you could win or lose the game off of that.
Sure.
But nowadays, it's kind of irrelevant. I mean, look what happened last game. We dies 4 times.
Yeah, and he still was such a beast that game, despite his terrible start.
It doesn't actually matter so much anymore. I think a lot of mid players kind of lament that fact.
Yeah.
I think Edendi in the past or something like that said... It sucks. I don't want to quote him for that, actually, so I'll just erase that.
But you can understand how a mid player who is a bit more mechanic-based and who is a little bit more focused on winning that one-versus-one matchup feels like there may be less skill involved to the mid matchup because there are all these outside external forces now that come into play. Windranger is going to be the last pick now. Ember Spirit carry for Team Secret, and they'll be putting the Windranger against the Queen of Pain. Alliance have left their support as the last pick, maybe because they felt like the Queen of Pain was going to be banned away, because they could have actually had the opportunity to have that mid-matchup advantage, I guess, in a way, where they see the enemy mid and then counter-pick it, but...
Man, you know what would be great? If this was, like, throw down to, like, Speed Gaming Days... Throwback, and then put Pylai Dai as the support Windranger. Let Envy play the carry Naga.
Oh, and then, Ember mid. Reserve
time. Remember that?
That would certainly be a
those
big
were the,
shocker.
Those were the days. Pylai Dai Windranger. It was like what Skywrath is now. He would just, like, walk in mid lane, right-click you 4 times with Windrun on, then go to the top lane and farm.
Alliance. I mean, technically, is there any offlaners that would be valuable for them? Because they could run a four position Tusk. Is there something left in the pool that they would consider making that switch?
I
I
don't
don't
think
really think
so.
so.
I think Nature's Prophet is quite bad this game.
There's like offlane Sand King, but
I don't think it's that good this game, though.
no, I don't think so either.
I think you get wrecked actually by all of these heroes.
So a support then. Rubick is still there. He's strong versus Clockwork in the laning phase for some potential. There, it offers a little bit of control. There's some okay steals, but not amazing. Whoa,
Oh.
sick! All right, Alliance pulling out the big guns here in game number three to try and keep their hopes alive here for the WCA qualifiers. Admiral Bulldog is going to be playing an offlane Doom, and they will be playing that four position Tusk.
Apparently, my nuts, by the way, is just nuts now.
Yeah, it's. And Mad is also seven Mad.
I just
Yeah.
call him mad.
I mean, there's so many better puns with my nuts.
Just call him nuts now.
All right.
That
So
is.
why do you go Doom? Okay, locks down the Ember Spirit, right? But what is has kept Doom from being a viable
20
offlaner?
seconds remaining. That you can doom creeps.
I wasn't even gonna pull out that meme, but
Let's see.
wait to once again stay one step ahead of
The
the
armor.
mockery.
The armor is pretty bad. You can't really contest carries. The buildup is a little bit too high. But I mean, Doom is still Doom. Ability that
Yeah.
makes everything so miserable.
It's the counter to everyone.
It is. Everyone always used to say Doom is the counter to Storm, but that's not true because he's the counter to everyone. Like,
Yeah.
there's no hero I want to play and get doomed by. Nothing makes that okay. There was a time period where I just play like mid rows. Because I was like trying to dissuade people from dooming me. Nope. If you're the mid hero, you're still getting doomed.
Wow.
And
All
it's
right.
still just as obnoxious.
So Admiral Bulldog is actually going boots first. Jesus, secret. They need to get a little bit of more, a little bit better communication when it comes to what they're gonna do in their pauses. First, it's a spike. Then Weehaw runs off to the bathroom. Puppy paws. Admiral Bulldog picked up boots. The matchup he's against, Dazzle and Naga Siren. First of all, the Naga Siren minus armor. You're already sitting at zero armor as a Doom. I can't imagine him actually trying to contest the offlane at all. I think he just goes straight jungle, right? But why does he go boots if
Because
that's the case?
he's gonna go see what he can do. You don't really need like you need Doom Jungle, like the Stealth Shield, no.
No.
You just need to get around camps. You could play this strategy called China Doom. Have you heard of it?
No.
What you do is you get Orb of Venom as your first item, and you get the Crit Wolf, and then you just run at the enemy mid when you're level 2 with flame fire. You know what we call it that?
Is he because player China?
What?
Okay, never mind. Maybe you don't know him.
When we were in Korea, we would play on the Chinese servers, and that would be like Chinese players would like first pick like argue over that who got to pick play it. You just went for the China Doom. Like the first time that happened to me, I was so surprised. I'm like a Storm with like full HP, and here comes this Doom with like 700 health and like a crit wolf, and he crits me twice with Orb of Venom and fire running, and I just die, and I'm just, what's going on?
I can just imagine you because you're like, the Doom's approach. All right, I'll fight him. And then it's just like, nope. But it's too late.
Yeah, ask Merlini or Aosin about it the next time you talk.
And a Doom. All right, so Admiral Bulldog is just gonna take a peek here. And I think one of the things that sort of surprises me again about Admiral Bulldog even trying the offlane here is the fact that I don't feel keeping the supports in the top lane is all that valuable because they don't have that strong ganking supports. for the middle lane. Like, Naga Siren's okay, but Dazzle certainly doesn't do much.
You don't need to, you don't actually have to gank this mid lane. Like, the Queen of Pain is pretty much ungankable anyways. Not with the Windranger.
Right.
But she's getting right-clicked so much. Well, he gets hit by the full duration burn, like all four hits.
And Weeha is forced to burn through his first shared Tango, of course. Pretty standard, he picks up the first, Yeah, I guess with the support already in middle lane, Admiral Bulldog will be able to get a little bit of time. And if this is Radiant side off lane, which is better for Doom, I guess, because he has that easy access to the hard camp.
Yeah, he also wants to force the supports up here. They have less time stacking and stuff like that.
Okay. Yeah. Makes sense. Yeah, they're going to go for the pull. Oh, wow. This actually works out so favorably because this Hellbear shouldn't be able to clear through the rest of the creep wave. This means the creep equilibrium is going to push in Admiral Bulldog's favor. Because they're expecting a full camp here, but it's half of it is gone with one of those Hellbears.
That Hellbear just, like, lost his friend. Just, like, disappeared. He got kidnapped.
What
can you imagine that? Like, your friend just, like, straight up by the devil.
All of a sudden, just Lucifer himself appears, yeah. Just eats you, and I'm left to solo cast after that?
Yeah, you can... I don't know how you function and act as a normal creep at that point.
Probably still get flamed by Reddit.
Somehow be your fault. The lane is pushing in though, and Bulldog, I think this was the wrong timing for it, because he actually pushed. He managed to get the wave to force over, but
yeah,
that was like a full wave and a half too. That would have been like level 3 already for him.
Well, a bit unfortunate. I think maybe he thought they stacked pull instead of going for the double pull. Misery. Oh, Mynuts is actually getting a lot of damage on Misery here. Not enough to kill him, unless Mynuts really just runs out there for the snowball. Cogs push back in, and Nuts! He ends up on the cliff. No. That was awkward.
All right,
so Admiral Bulldog
goes back
now.
Top.
Back up to top lane, missing out on that experience situation. Needs to cut over and eat the camp again. Yeah, if he just continued this over and over again, every single time they pulled, it was just like, oh, it's not a full camp. Still, though, I can see where the boots are coming into handy, because if he's going to be bouncing back and forth between these lanes so much, he needs the extra movement speed.
Again,
maybe he'll even go for the Tranquil Boots.
I think it's just more that you don't go for anything else.
Yeah.
You don't have to. Going for the boots alone is fine.
Does he take something else here? The armor? Yeah, the armor. Too valuable on a Doom. How's our mid matchup? We haven't actually talked about it too much. Focusing on Bulldog. Way too much.
The Queen of Pain is destroying.
Yeah, it really is. S4 has to pop his health, but oh! Jeez. That was close. That flare almost killed half of his health.
Oh, and he gets a
potion.
Full bottle, too.
Alright, now he's back. Weeha's gonna be caught up here. The Ice Shards. He does not have a Shackle. One more mana, has it now. S4 just trying to get that extra bit of damage, but with Puppy here, there's no way they can get that kill. Bottom lane, Misery gets a successful Cogs push out on both Lota and Ake, so they won't be able to catch him. Unless Lota really commits with the phase boots. By the time he actually catches up to Misery, he's just going to be so far. Oh, what an Ice Shards block!
Okay, now you go for... Okay, no. They're wasting a lot of time.
I mean, he has Cogs again, there's no way.
They wasted a lot of time debating that, though.
Yeah, they really did. S4, be careful, friend. Weeha goes for the shot! Oh, S4, he's already healed up with this bottle and will be able to get the free refill once again.
Weeha, though, is going to get some help out. That regen rune, and this is going to kind of help out, but S4 is still doubling him in CS. The regen is definitely going to allow him just to trade really efficiently.
The ganking dazzle. Doesn't really mean much to Admiral Bulldog, but he's still sitting packed just in case. Gets caught by the ensnare, that means then the Searing Chains is going to come out. He will probably die. He's actually going to fight this one because Mynuts is coming in with the TP. They're going to be able to snowball, say, Admiral
That's
Bulldog. And it's just the bait's secret in entirely. Lota's going to be able to clean up, I think, one of these supports. Puppy is going to be the target. S4 actually comes in. A little bit of body blocking just to make sure that Puppy does, in fact, go down here. And at the same time, they do finally catch the Dazzle. Took them a while. They're going to go for Eternal Envy now. Lota, careful.
You got it back. They don't have
There's
mana.
No way.
He's
no
also mana. Been saving Flame Guard. He was going for the outplay.
Oh, yeah.
That would have been sick.
It's hit by the Ice Shard. S4 actually comes forward. Jackie tried to turn, but unfortunately the Ice Shard's kind of blocked him out.
I think he would have killed him too.
Yeah.
That's insane. Jackie played that really well. Trying to bait for like the fact that, because S4 probably thinks to himself, oh, if he had it, he would have used it by now.
Mm-hmm. Still, though, really great coordination by Alliance, setting up the bait on Admiral Bulldog, knowing the snowball would buy him so much time. And S4, oh, he's going to get chained up. He's actually dead. Tries to bottle through in between hits, but that's not enough to save him. And that actually turns everything back around to Secret's favor, because those heavy rotations freed up so much room for Misery to get experience at this bottom lane, and then they still feed away the Queen of Pain. Now, they get the both the best worlds. The safe lane actually gets significant gold and experience off the mid laner kill, and both the solos get a lot of free time.
You were talking about it. It's they get the net, they were going to kill Bulldog. And, I mean, Secret's not dumb, they realize that, but yeah. It's if it's too good to be true, it always is in professional play. Mm. That?
Free kill on the Wisp?
I can go for this.
Oh, yeah, totally.
It never works out like that.
Oh. Alliance are just too crafty, that's for sure.
Lota, though, just continuing to plug away and farm. But he is so far behind now, the Ember. Which is not something you typically see, because the Gyrocopter can usually... He has really good attack animation, and the Ember Spirit usually gets pressured pretty hard.
Is Misery dead? Ice Shard still blocking him out, but the Cogs do push him back. Now the rotation, Jackie's actually going to come in. Eternal Envy trying to eat through my nuts, but still, they have the Cold Embrace to be able to keep him alive a little bit longer, but there's no Snowball save either, so he will eventually die. That was a full mid and carry rotation to the bottom lane.
I think, though, that this is well worth it for Secret. Just because they can afford to make these rotations. Like, look at the CS difference between the Ember and the Gyrocopter, and how it's reflected in the net worth. Gyrocopter is actually behind the Doom, who didn't even really have a lane with when it comes to net worth.
Oh, Shackle, S4. Gonna be caught there. Weeha had a power shot, but they need a little bit more damage.
I'm pretty surprised right now.
I think this is the... I really like the general idea of putting the Ember Spirit in the off lane. When you have the maxed out flame guard, because no one can really threaten you. And it just soaks up so much magic damage, you know?
Yeah, he's just gonna probably TP back to base, then immediately port bottom again. He's gonna realize that he can't go for this rune.
Snowball doesn't catch. You know, Blitz. I once had a game as Tusk where I made that sort of play. I tried to catch somebody TPing out. And the snowball kept going, and I ended up. It was the same scenario, and I ended up on the cliff.
Yeah, I was actually just about to comment. That would be really unfortunate if Nuts ended up on there.
That's the worst.
Both of best worlds. Is that what I said?
Ember Spirit clearing through a nice little two stack. And has his bottle to work with. This is the same kind of Eternal Envy play that we saw when he picks up Clinks. Like, he gets his basic amount of farm in the laning phase, and then he moves into the enemy jungle, into that enemy offlane, and just creates that constant pressure between middle and the safe lane, and then takes over the jungle at the same time. It limits the enemy's farm so much. As long as he's able to do it without getting caught. Now, we'll see whether or not this happens with this smoke gank.
They've got Doom.
Yeah, they could get him. Admiral Dog, he gets the Doom off, and Eternal Levy's dead.
This is the strength of Doom, the ability Doom. You walk up and kill people and there's not a whole lot they can do, and Admiral Bulldog actually has pretty unbelievable net worth right now, and it's not like it's going to slow down. Like, Doom will just continue to get ahead at this rate. Got full completed Tranquil Boots. He's going to Midas another creep. I don't know, it'll be like second in net worth almost.
Fresh in my memory here, Blitz.
Shoot.
What do you go on Doom at this point? Do you go Blink Dagger Ags?
Yeah, that's not even a bad build to go whatsoever. Okay. Some people I've seen go for the Shadow Blade, but there's a really cool combination that I think it was like Winter showed me, is like you go Blink on Doom and then you grab the Centaur. So you Blink War Stomp.
Oh, okay.
And you can stun somebody for 2 seconds and then you guarantee the Doom. as well. It's just a really nice initiation.
Isn't there still an animation on more stomp though?
It's like, I mean, you can do both at the same time.
Yeah, I guess that was like the Doom animation and the War Stomp animation can't be that different, right?
Yeah.
Still, I mean, an AoE stun, Link in AoE stun is always valuable.
For sure. He's got a lot of good Doom targets this game too. He is going to get a Ring of Bassy. He's starting to realize, like, mana is an issue. I haven't played this hero in forever.
Yeah, that's why I was... And you'd be able to help me with item builds. It feels like it's been forever and a year since I've casted a Doom game.
I had a lot of smokes for the gank. Puppy, though, trademark, farming like crazy. Already has arcane boots as a support. No support for Puppy. He's almost up to the Clockwork's net worth.
Nuts. Gotta keep himself out of the hands of Puppy and Misery. Got the hookshot ready to go, and the ultimate from the Song of Siren to be able to back out once they commit for a kill as well. And now, Weehaw is actually getting some information thanks to this intelligence rune.
Intelligence? Invisrun.
Yeah. Two I words. Too complicated for me.
They're gonna spot this rotation though. So Weehaw.
Oh, top lane! Oh, just barely managed to get the kill on the gyrocopter solo.
That is. Hey, the gyro's game is.
Done for.
Yeah, it's actually so crippled right now.
Move over, Loda. Time to play support. Admiral Bulldog's gonna go carry.
It kinda is already.
Yeah.
The net worth of the Queen of Pain and the Ember are gonna be really what propels this game. The net worth of the gyrocopter who had to lane against the clockwork, they're almost equivalent right now.
Whoa, S4, he blinked in so aggressively for that one. He's gonna be able to get Snowball saved, kinda, and the Song of Siren goes out. Misery. Oh god, he got blocked in by Emerald Bulldog. Keep running, Misery. He will get out. The rest of Team Secret also TP in. S4 is still really low. But I don't think Team Secret can push it. So Puppy rotates up to the top lane. That was really awkward. I mean, S4 blinking in so aggressively like that, but play by Nuts with the snowball save.
It's another smoke used, and the gyrocopter continues to not farm. When he does this, it's okay, and I think this is the right maneuver. They have to get a big target out of this, or at least accomplish something. Like, we get a kill on Wii and then go for a tower push. But something has to happen as a result of this. They're gonna run into Jackie.
Ember, that's perfect. They get a Doom on him. They'll quickly clean up Eternal Envy. And the rest of Alliance can now actually take control of this Tier 1 tower. It's funny, if they'd gone for Wii, there would have been a great response from Team Secret because they had the supports sitting in these trees. But Alliance, okay, I thought they were actually just, since they're there, 5-man push the Tier 1, but they back up to farm some more.
You have no Doom. Jackie respawns in decent amount of time. I don't think it's a bad play whatsoever by Alliance. Not even like, S4 was quite low too. I don't think you can risk that. The potential to just be power shot, rocket flare spammed is really high.
Medallion already for Pilot Eye. Puppy is gonna go for the mech route on the Naga Siren. Picked Glimmer Cape eventually out of him as well. We have the Blade Mail that's almost finished on Misery. Got the most expensive items first, so not too far away. And that'll really play havoc, especially with the Gyrocopter because it's already been shut down significantly. Won't have that fast BKB. There's going to be such a large period of time where he's susceptible to that Blade Mail. S4, gonna be challenged here, the chains, and they just pop him so quickly. The Winter's Curse, it wouldn't have even saved S4. The burn damage still would have been there.
Chains are insane against heroes like Anti-Mage and Queen of Pain. Because they rely on being able to animation dodge stuff, the low-moving stuns and stuff like that, but you can't play the positional game against the chains. Oh, it almost always land in that position. And since they're level 4, that 3-second disable that also deals like a third of your HP. You're gonna get wrecked by that pretty hard. I mean, a large part of this game just comes down to Bulldog now.
Yeah.
Queen of Pain and the Gyrocopter have been slowed down quite a bit. But if Bulldog can still have an insane game, like, they're still okay.
Is there any difference, do you think, in item build between the offlane and in carry Doom? Like if he's going, okay, my gyrocopter is just becoming a non-factor, do you try and go the tank up build where you get like Shiva's AC?
You're gonna get that anyways,
Yeah.
but you
You
still
still
want a
want
blink
eggs.
dagger. Blink dagger Aghs is still pretty big on Ember.
Okay.
You can solo kill Ember, which is pretty rare because not a lot of heroes can, because of that instant initiate or that instant back ability from Ember. Ember sees anybody; he can just hit one button. Doesn't even have to be pointing on the map. You can just do it on the mini map. Click any general direction, and you'll get away.
Misery is biding his time right now, waiting for someone to show up. Doesn't look like he'll get the opportunity. They're actually gonna go for Roche. Oh, with a double damage. That'll make things a lot easier. So, Medallion, double damage, Windranger with Focus Fire. Roshan is well in hand for Team Secret.
They're gonna give this, I think, to their Ember, but in some ways, I actually don't even know. It just depends. Do they really want to get into fighting shape with him early on? I think this just changes the Doom target to the Windranger instead.
Yeah.
But he's got enough backup. He's got the Naga Siren and the Dazzle to be able to follow up. His laning phase had to go a little bit better. That means the Winner's Curse is going to be even more important for Make.
Yeah, that Child Grave's gonna be such a killer.
It always is.
The against the Doom specifically. I mean, if you think about it, if you get it at the right time, that cuts the Doom time by 33%. You know?
Yeah, and you can just constantly heal on top of that.
Yeah,
Becomes
the
really rough. He steals the mana burn. I assume that's just a temporary measure because
Yeah.
that's not a good thing to have.
He had the small purge creep earlier. He's trying to use the efficiency of Devour by killing some of the small creeps when he can. Oh, they caught Misery. They throw a lot for it, and Jackie's actually going to try and take advantage of that one. Nuts, he's not going to be able to survive. The cold brace isn't enough. Jackie walks away with a double kill, but he's going to be doomed up immediately. The call down gets laid out, and there goes the Aegis, but still, Eternal Envy got the two kills. That was well worth it for him.
Oh, easily. Especially on a hero like Ember this early into the game. I'm really happy about that. He's almost got the fully completed Battle Fury now, just 18 minutes into the game. He's had a pretty stellar game, despite the two dooms that went off on him. Third of the game, and Admiral Bulldog has just kind of set the tone. He's like, I'm always going to doom you, by the way.
S4 going for the Orchid over the Aghanim Scepter.
He needs it. The Ags is, I don't think it's going to be enough to deal with. For example, they need to be able to silence the Grave and the Naga Siren.
Yeah, you got to take out the Dazzle. You got to silence up the Dazzle as well as the Ember Spirit in a lot of
Yeah.
these fights, right?
Probably even more importantly, the Naga.
Right.
You get like
Saga
Doom's
Siren.
puppy just resets with the Naga Siren, and Ember runs away, gets healed, lays down the spirit, goes to base, and then they can continue the fight. It'd be huge.
There's just too many targets that Alliance need to control when they initiate.
You have a Doom and an Orchid.
Still though, I mean, you try and orc it up and maybe pop the Naga Siren, but then there's going to be that Shallow Grave on one of the two targets.
I mean, it's not an ideal situation, Cap.
Yeah.
There's a lot of different heroes you have to crowd control. I mean, I like Secret's lineup in general. They've got a mech on the Naga too. It's gonna help a lot. Gotta cut through a lot of different healing.
Probably goes Glimmer Cape next into Guardian Greaves after.
Yeah, it's a really solid build for this game. Glimmer Cape, I don't think cuts down on the Doom damage here now.
Yeah.
But it's still, just to get that distance away from the Doom would be pretty significant,
Yeah, and
especially when Doom has Aghs.
it's still very strong. Misery's actually trying to challenge S4. He's gonna pop the Blade Mail at the last second here, hoping S4 would burst some damage onto him, but that's not gonna be the case. Misery will fall.
Everybody from Secret kind of rotating up. Wea's gonna throw the power shot out, but Alliance is just gonna get out.
Yeah, mass TP's back. 9200. Eternal Envy gonna be the first to break that 10k marker. Already has the Battle Fury. Lincoln's next, maybe for the Ember Spirit before you go Crystallis.
Yeah.
Kind of a necessity.
It'd be huge just because the Doom has to waste his time casting both abilities on you at once. You definitely have time to get out. at that phase. Dealing damage is not your issue right now, especially when the Ember, or the, not the Ember, but the Gyro is as underfarmed as he is, just about staying alive. Lota's gonna go for the quick BKB though. I think this is the right decision. I think going for the SNY and build of that nature is a little bit too late now.
Yeah. Your stat-based build isn't going to be nearly as effective as it would 5 minutes ago.
When you go for that build, you have to be able to take advantage of your mobility and how far of a lead you have over everybody else in the early game. That isn't the case here.
Yeah, I think that's why Bloodseeker was one of the bans out in the second phase by Alliance, because I feel like the Rupture just limits one of the biggest strengths of the Gyrocopter, which is that mobility you're talking about.
They banned it every game.
Yeah.
Not a surprise, the hero's a pain to play against.
Focus Fire on the tier 2 at the bottom lane, and they're not even getting the tier 1 top. Eternal Envy is defending that one solo. This is just Alliance forced to make a really bad trade-off here. Shackle Shot will actually launch in, but oh no! Nice dodge there from Lota. Gets away from that hook shot. Now pops the call down. Misery's going to try and turn some of the damage with the Blade Melody activated, but he will be able to get out. Now double chain snowball save. Actually brings them together, but it only puts them deeper in the base. S4 is going to be able to get off a Sonic Wave. Still not enough to finish anybody off. Winter's Curse on a Weehawk, but the Song of the Siren is making things a pain for Alliance. Now Nut starts getting himself away. S4, nice control. Shackle Shot able to take him out. There goes Tusk as well. Gyrocopter in the background ends up falling, and Jackie is going to run down Admiral Bulldog. Gets the Slide of Fist, chains, 4 kills for Team Secret, and not dropping a beat.
And now Secret have an overwhelming advantage. There's still a glyph. No, there's not actually. I had somebody from Secret selected. So they have no glyph. They've got a pretty big advantage just because they know the Doom is down. Puppy doesn't have that mech up quite yet, but they're just going to kill Ake now too because he's the only one alive. You're probably not going to use a buyback just to save him. And at the same time, I think Secret has also realized there's no buyback. So Pylai Dai is just going to spam heal on the ground. Ember Spirit will just come back in when he can.
Oh, he's actually going to go for the Blink Dagger build.
Okay, I like that. Positional game. Doesn't really matter at this phase. He knows that the Doom is down right now.
Hook shot on Alota. Blink, blink, blink. Oh, he's going to be orking it up. Maybe tread a little bit too deep there, but Pylai Dai ready with the Shell Grave last second. And he's going to try and TP back, but I feel like the damage is still going to be there, sure enough. The kill. They're going to jump forward now, trying to catch anybody, but Jackie's still plenty strong. Eternal Envy, that Blink Dagger, the max mobility, and there's a three-man smoke behind him from Team Secret. They're not going to challenge anymore. No need to get greedy at this point in time. They got the melee racks. They got what they came for.
Yeah, now the Winner's Curse again, it's just not doing anything in this game like you want it to. Because if you cast it on the Windranger, well, who's really going to deal damage to her? It almost feels like they're just purely drafting around that hero. Because in the last game too, it was like, okay, you Winner's Curse the Spectre, what? There's no physical damage. There's no heroes like the Gyrocopter or like an Anti-Mage that'll actually make it worth it, right? And in this game, it's similar too, because if you don't have Focus Fire going, the Windranger doesn't deal that much damage.
Bouncing around, trying to catch a pickoff on Alliance. The Blink Dagger is going to be able to allow him to catch up to Ake. Winter's Curse laid out, and Ake will actually manage to get out, but they got the Doom, or sorry, the Tusk. Looks like another great Shackle Shot. Weehawk using the Blink Dagger as much as possible. Does end up finding the kill for the trade-off of that Tier 1 tower. Still, though, we're talking about Alliance claiming a Tier 1 tower, and they've already lost to Melee Racks. Only 24 minutes in.
Yeah, if Secret want, they can just wait it out and go for the Roshan and then really secure the game for themselves. They're building up quite the lead and the bankroll. Guardian Greaves, like you said, completed on the Naga Siren. You've almost got a 4 staff completed on Misery if he wants it eventually. And it's not like this Windranger and Ember Spirit are bad cores to have in the late game either. And nobody from Secret is really keeping, or not Secret Alliance, is really keeping up anymore. Doom, the effectiveness of the hero really goes down once it comes down to these like 5-man engagements repeatedly, and you have to like doom 5 different targets, especially when there's just not an ideal target to go for.
Oh, he got the golem. He's gonna be split into little baby dooms. Ew, baby dooms. Arr.
Immediately dies.
Rest in peace, Shard. Pansry's just sitting here going, what the hell was that? Still waiting for someone to pop out from Alliance down this staircase. Meanwhile, Loda has to run away from the Tier 2 tower defense. Just one hero is enough to threaten him. And Secret, they're just not making any mistakes. They're finding the pickoffs. They're slowly taking these objectives. Just corralling Alliance inside of the base bit by bit.
They're going to go for the underrated Rex. This is a lot of gold. This is like a tower worth of gold for everybody.
Oh, yeah.
This just extends the lead even further.
They buffed that in the last patch, right?
Yeah. This is 10k now at 25 minutes in. Roshan spawns in under a minute, too. They're just going to take out all the tier 2s, go for Roshan, and then you can breach the high ground.
Poor staff clockwork. Chrysalis for Weeha. Again, we're seeing these teams, once they build into an advantage, this was picked up, I think, like, probably 6, maybe 8 minutes ago, but the gem, I believe that was Pilot Eyes. Then handing it off over to the Naga Siren, who uses it so efficiently with the illusions. Just really limits Alliance's openings.
Yeah, denying vision, it means that Alliance are pretty much stuck inside their base, and they're waiting for the high ground defense to come in. But Secret, I mean, they don't even have to waste their time. They can just go for the Roshan first.
Yeah, exactly.
Continue to pile on, and you've got a fully completed data list almost on the Windranger. Wait, does she actually have it? She doesn't. She does have the crit on both heroes, though, on both cores. Now they're going to go for the Roshan.
Yeah, it looks like Ember Spirit's the one closer to that data list. Just needs another 1100 gold and he'll have it.
I think this one goes on Weeha.
Yeah,
because they need him to go high ground.
Yeah, he's the one that sits there with the focus fire. Which means that he's the target they want to be able to doom, but not with the Aegis.
He's the heavy damage dealer that they can't really kill. He's got Grave, Guardian Greaves, and the Naga Song reset. Can't imagine them killing this Windranger anymore.
Oh, Loda forced into a BKB usage there. That's gonna hurt. Admiral Bulldog, his smoke isn't gonna work out. Shackle Shot doesn't latch to anything. And Weeha's actually stuck in the Ice Shards, but he'll be okay.
Still a BKB used. I think they have Glyph. Yeah, they do. So that's one minor consolation prize. They've got Glyph available, but you traded a Clockwork Hookshot cooldown for the BKB 10 second charge. 45 seconds left on that. I don't actually think it's really quite possible anymore for them to continue to go on.
Oh, Shackle Shot. Maybe this is their opening. S4 is actually just going to go down to this. Weeha just deals out so much damage in that focus fire. So they've got a full minute to take advantage of that pickoff, thanks to Weeha and his Shackle Shot. Time to go uphill. Time to show Team Secret. They want to go to WCA. They want to be moving on to these grand finals against Virtus Pro. Oh. A little bit awkward. Misery looks like he missed his hook. Jackie just gonna barrel right in and trying to finish off nuts. Can't quite get it. Makes his jump back to the remnant. Meanwhile, the tier 3 tower does go down. Shackle Shot jump forward. Admiral Bulldog was hoping to be able to get Jackie, but the Shackle Shot followed him, and he may not be able to get that much off. Actually, Winter's Curse, but still, the Doom Link does go down, and now the pop up in the air. Weeha's going to be able to survive through even that much. They can't even take away the Aegis. Loda's going to fall as well. They only have a buyback on Gyro here. Misery is actually going to go to S4. They jump over to Ake at the same time. Misery kept alive by the Discarding Grease. They can't even get him. Team Secret, they've only lost the Aegis so far. Now Loda comes back with a second life, immediately gets taken out. Alliance, no, it's all over. They just barrel right in to see what they can do, but the writing was on the wall, 7-21, and Team Secret will finally beat Alliance 2-1 in this semifinal.
I mean, great game by them in game number 3. They had a strategy, they executed it. They countered the Winter's Curse really well, just dealing with the fact that they had no physical damage dealers. And